Today, let's talk about a very special case study of a client who came to see me because of porn-induced erectile dysfunction. This person was still consuming porn, although controlling it a bit, but had struggled and suffered from and with erectile dysfunction for a decade. Now, this person was in the neurofeedback program, very targeted neurofeedback program that I offer at very high levels for 4 months. 4 months later, this person no longer was consuming porn and their erectile dysfunction had remediated itself. I'm going to share visuals of the person's brain map, of the person's trend screen over time, that showing you with quantitative measurable data how this person's brain changed over time. So this is an awesome episode. We're going to have the visuals in it also on YouTube. If you're listening to this in audio player, you can check out the visuals there. You also can see the visuals at drtrishleigh.com on the blog post. Without further ado, welcome back to the Dr. Trish Leigh podcast with me, your hostess with the mostest, Dr. Trish Leigh. Today, we are going to break down porn-induced erectile dysfunction, what causes it, how you can see it in the brain, and most importantly, what you can do to get rid of it quickly. So let us dive into the science after I remind you that this podcast is part of my outreach program, and it is sponsored by the nonprofit organization that I founded, Porn Brain Prevention. You can find it at pornbrainprevention.org. It is designed to help children and young people never get hooked on porn. This mission is more important than ever before because kids are the ones primarily who are consuming porn. Porn in their pockets. I know no parent wants to admit that, and I know because I have 5 beautiful children. But it's the truth. So help me go upstream so we can teach parents and we can help kids avoid the dangers of porn consumption. You can donate over at pornbrainprevention.org, and I appreciate all the donations very much. All right, let's dive in. So here's what we're doing today. We are going to talk about a client very near and dear to my heart who, when I first met him, a lot of people tell me they're skeptics. They've suffered from ED for over a decade. How could I possibly help them? If you have met me and if you meet me in a QEEG brain map, which I'm running a special where I'm doing QEEG brain maps during the month of May and June, and I think it's May 15th to June 15th, if I'm remembering correctly, you will hear me say, I love a good skeptic. I have worked with thousands of people, probably tens of thousands of people. I know I can help a person when I see the dysfunction in their brain on a QEEG brain map. I know exactly what needs to be done. Then I set the technology using very advanced protocols that honestly nobody else knows about besides me. And then they're proprietary. Then I set those protocols. I monitor them. I change them if they need to be changed. And the coaches on my team help you by using your mind and your body to synergize the brain rewiring that is happening by itself using the Dr. Trish Leigh app. So this is really cool, advanced neuroscience technology. It's been around for 75 years. People think I invented it in my basement. If you've met me, I'm a thought person, not a tinker with wires person. So of course I work with the top company in the world who is the power behind my app. I'm not doing this alone. It's been around for 75 years, but thankfully I'm blessed to have fallen in love with QEEG brain mapping neurofeedback. So I have learned to use it at very high levels over some decades. So this is the way that it works. This client came to me. He told me, I'm a skeptic. And I'm like, not the first time I heard that, my friend. I went through his brain map with him. And what I call strain brain was off the charts. Excessive amounts of high beta. High beta is very fast energy. It is the energy that makes you feel stressed out. It makes you feel hypervigilant. It makes you feel the need to self-soothe desperately. I could see that the levels of high beta were incredibly high in his brain map, which means now I know exactly what needs to be done to shift that brain map so that high beta can come down. I start with neurofeedback brain training, but then again, we use your mind and body. If we do this, if we change, nuance some of the activities in your life, especially staying away from porn, your brain can rewire itself in a very quick amount of time. So on the brain map, it showed very high levels of high beta. I went in, I set the protocols for the exact areas of his brain that were impacted, and I set it for the exact parameters. There are many areas, there are many parameters. So when I simplify it into strain brain, it's so you can understand, but there's actually a lot going on in the background. So I know what all those things are. I consider all the variables and then I set a very specific protocol for each person. So I did this for this client and he proclaimed to me that he's not doing anything else. He's not going to do anything else because, you know, he wants to see if this is going to work. And he started to do the training. The training is like a workout for your brain. So if you start working your body out and you don't believe workouts are going to make your body stronger, will they? Yeah, they will. Of course, right? Workouts make your body stronger. They can't not. So it's the same thing with neurofeedback brain training workouts. If you start doing them, you don't have to believe it's going to work. You just have to do it. And when you do it, your brain actually gets stronger. So a few weeks later, we meet again, and he is astonished at how differently he already feels. Of course, I can see that his brain is performing in a very different manner or mode. I can see it. I can see his brain has changed. So he tells me, yes, indeed, he does feel different. And of course, people test me too. I'm on to them when they're testing me. So if you've tested me, I was on to you. I know you're testing me. I'm just going to interpret the data for you. I'm not going to make up a story. I'm going to tell you what the data says. The story, I'm going to read the story of the data. And the story of this gentleman's data said, strain brain came down a lot within 20 days. Now, not all people's brains come down really super fast in 20 days. The way I think about it is we have fast trainers, medium trainers, and slow trainers. It's just like workouts. Some people start working out and their muscles are defined 2 weeks later, right? My bestie, she starts working out. She's got 0.3% body fat. I work out every single day for an hour. I do not have 0.3 body fat. We're different people. So she's a very fast trainer because of her metabolism. You know, I fall in the category of medium to slow, probably, but that's a story for a different time. Most people fall within the medium. You start working out, there's subtle changes, but there's not dramatic changes in the first few weeks. You have to stay at it for a couple of months, and then you can feel and look different. So medium trainers, slow trainers, you know you're feeling a little better. And with the workouts too, you know you're getting in shape, but it's not showing up in your weight. You weigh yourself every day. You've lost 0.25 pounds, but you know the workouts are good for you. You can feel it. So fast, medium, slow trainers. This gentleman, fast trainer. Love seeing a fast training brain. It's amazing because those people feel great quickly. And then knowing that you're getting better is huge. Seeing it in the data and being able to connect it to feeling a little bit better or a lot of bit better, that's very powerful.